Nice to see you. I think the last time I spoke to you, you were preparing for a game at Liverpool. You look like a different person. You look like you're in a different place. And you look like you have a squad of players who are perhaps better equipped to go and get a result somewhere like Anfield. Jurgen Klopp said you've turned Tottenham into a results machine.
I'm the same guy. Nothing changed. It's just perception. Jurgen says that because if you look to our results this season, we lost one in the Premier League and we lost one in Europa League, so our results are very positive. But I think it's too early, and the period of good results is about a few months. And a results machine, of course, is much more than that. A result machine is what Liverpool has been for the past couple of years. A result machine was what my Chelsea was in the period we won the two consecutive titles. We are a good team that works hard, but I would say Liverpool is the result of, if I'm not wrong, 1,894 days of work with Jurgen. 1,894, if I'm wrong, I'm wrong for a few days. And we are the result of a work of 390 days, but these 390 days are fake because probably lots of these days were not even days of work, were days of quarantine, were days being at home unable to work. So from almost 2,000 to 300, for us to be able to compete at the level we are doing, I can only give credit to the players and be very, very happy with what they are doing.
In that time though, Jose, how much has the mentality of the players going into big games like this strengthened, and how much is that important going to somewhere like Anfield where Tottenham have kind of historically struggled?
You know, I don't think that it's Tottenham that historically struggles at Anfield, especially if you look at the results they are having in the last couple or maybe more than that years. Everybody struggles there because nobody wins there. And even other clubs with good records at Anfield, they struggle to get good results. So it's as simple as that. It's true that this season we managed to get good results against the top teams, but that doesn't mean much. It's an isolated game. It's a game where we don't change our philosophy, we don't change our wishes. We want to win. And then you can tell me, yes, 2 minutes ago you told us 1,894 days against 390 days. Yes. But we go there to try to win the match. Is the way we think this season. And it's not about being top of the league or no, is nothing. It's just about we go there and we want to try to win.
You've had supporters in for a couple of games. That's now on hold. There'll be fans at Anfield tomorrow. Is it just a good thing that supporters are at games, whether they're home and away, if possible, if you know allowed?
You know, I'm so confused with all that, not just as at the football level, but also and especially at the social level. I'm so confused with contradictions. I'm so confused to understand why this decision, why that decision. Of course, I'm a football man. I'm not a politician or scientist, but I'm too confused to make any comment.
Can I just ask you finally about Gerard Houllier? I imagine your paths crossed a lot at UEFA, and certainly he was someone who made his mark at Liverpool.
I didn't make any comment because I was, of course, respecting the ones that were really, really close to Gerard, and I always believe that they are the ones that have to express their feelings in the moment. So people like Jamie Carragher and guys that played with him and guys that work with him every day, the coach at Salzburg. And I preferred yesterday to be very respectful with that. But Gerard was an amazing guy, and I had the privilege to share with him so many meetings in UEFA, in FIFA, because since he finished his career, he was always involved in these technical things, and such a nice guy, And of course, I feel very sorry. And tomorrow at Anfield, you will have the possible homage. It's a pity that the stadium is not full and the Liverpool fans could express their feelings to such a great guy.
Okay, thank you, James. We're going to go on to another James now. James from TalkSport, just unmuting you.
Hi, Jose. Spurs have lost their last five matches against Liverpool, but when you consider the run that your side is on and the confidence that seems to be building, can you go to Anfield with real belief tomorrow?
You know, I never liked this kind of stats, because football, every event is an isolated event. You know, when I play against Newcastle, you tell me that I never win in Newcastle, but then we won. When you tell me I always win against the team A, then I lose against the team A. You know, matches are isolated events. So I don't look to these numbers. I look to why Liverpool gets so many consecutive good results at home. Why? And start from there. Don't start from the last five times Liverpool won against Tottenham, or the last 10 times this or that. It's just why they have so many good results at home. And start from there. And from there, trying to go in a way where we can win, which of course is such a difficult thing that nobody did it for the past X months or X matches. But we are going to try to win.
You managed to keep the unbeaten run going at Selhurst Park on Sunday, but is there anything that wasn't there on Sunday that you'd like to see tomorrow from your players?
I'm not worried about the unbeaten run. If you want the unbeaten run and we want a draw, we don't play against Crystal Palace the way we did it in the last 15 minutes, because in the last 15 minutes we should then try to close the door and get a point to be unbeatable. We don't want to be unbeatable. We want to win matches, and every time we don't win, we are not happy with the with the results. I told, and I can repeat what the players did in the second half against Crystal Palace was not what I asked them to do. But if they didn't what I told them to do, was because they couldn't. Was because the opponent is powerful, is because the opponent also played, is because the opponent reacts, is because the opponent creates difficulties. So we don't change from here.
And just finally from me, Jose, what are you expecting from Liverpool tomorrow? Because it's been quite a difficult start, saying that they're still joint top alongside Spurs, but the injury list is mounting up. So what sort of team are you expecting to face?
Well, I think Alisson is not injured. Alexander Arnold is not injured. Matip, I believe that he's going to play. Fabinho is not injured. Robertson is not injured. Anderson is not injured. Wijnaldum is not injured. Salah is not injured. Firmino is not injured. Mané is not injured. Van Dijk is injured. And Van Dijk is a very good player, of course. But give me Liverpool list of injuries and compare that list of injuries with what is the best Liverpool team. And then I can give you a list of 10 injuries at Tottenham. We have two kids of the under 16 with injuries. We have two other in the under 21, and we have three in the under 23. We have Lamela and Tanganga, and here you have a list of 10 players. But is Lloris injured? No. Alderweireld injured? No. Dier injured? No. Reguilón injured? No. Harry Kane injured? No. Son injured? No. Lucas injured? No. So where are the injuries? There are injuries normal. It's normal. James Milner is injured. Lamela is injured. You know, and every club has now and again injuries. Liverpool has a big injury, which is Van Dijk.
Okay, I'm going to go to Nick Godwin at BBC. Nick, I'm unmuting you.
Hi, Jose. Is Gareth Bale going to be available for tomorrow?
We still have training session this afternoon. Yesterday, he didn't train with the team. He trained inside, not even outside. In this moment, I would say no, but let's wait for feelings and let's see the training session at 3 o'clock.
Okay, thank you, Nick. We will go to Jonathan Veal now. Jonathan, I'm just unmuting you.
Hi there, Jody. Harry Winks recently said when he was away with England that he needs lots of minutes to sort of force his way into Gareth Southgate's team for Euros. He's obviously not getting a lot of games.
It's a big noise.
Right from your house, John?
It might be a washing machine.
Might be a washing machine, okay.
yeah, stop so Harry Winks didn't get a lot of game time in the Premier League. Is that something that he's come to you and spoken to you about, and how has he been, you know, behind the scenes?
If he spoke with me?
Yes.
Why do you ask that? Because you know?
No, that's why I'm asking, because I don't know.
Are you asking me for me to confirm?
Yes.
Ah, so you know?
No, I don't know.
You know, yes, you know. Yes, he come to me. Yeah. He come to me, but not just him. Not just him. Many players, they come to me. Many players, they come to me. I have my office on the first floor, but I have also a little space on the ground floor next to the players' dressing room, where I used to be before and after the training session to make it easier for them. So it's so easy for them just to go around the corner and to speak with me. So yes, Winks come to speak with me, yes.
Okay, Ali Gold, I'm coming to you.
Hi there, Jose. Can I just ask you, you mentioned the injuries there. Obviously, Eric Lamela stood out. Did you say Japhet Tanganga's picked up another injury then?
Yes.
What yes, exactly is that?
Against Antwerp, on his shoulder. Sorry, no need of surgery. We believe that conservative treatment will get him fit. That's what the medical department believes, but a couple of weeks, 3 weeks, we'll keep him out.
And can I just ask you, Giovanni Lo Celso and Tongi Ndombele both seem to be getting fitter. At the moment in the Premier League, obviously you're using one or the other and they're replacing each other as a substitute. How difficult is that decision becoming for you over which one to start in each game?
No, it's not difficult. Difficult is when you don't have any one of them, and then you want one and you don't have. Can they both play together? Yes, they can. You are right. The physical condition for both is very important to play with these two players together. We need them to be fit. We need them to be with the right intensity, and they will, and they will play together. I'm not saying if that game is tomorrow, is Sunday, or is next week. I'm not saying that, but they will play together. But it's is not a problem at all when I have both growing up and playing quite well.
Okay, I'm going to finish with Katie Shanahan for the broadcast bit, then we'll move on to the dailies. Katie.
Afternoon, Jose. Ending Liverpool's impressive league run at home and beating the champions would arguably be Tottenham's biggest statement yet. But how difficult will it be playing them at Anfield?
We don't want to make any statement. We just want to play a game and win it. And if we don't win it, and the responsibility of that is Liverpool's responsibility, then great. If it's our responsibility, because we are not able to perform well, then would be a worse feeling, of course. But we are not there to make any kind of statement. It doesn't matter the result. On Thursday morning, we will be here. And Sunday we'll be playing again to win again. It's not a statement, it's just a match. But I don't hide that we go there and our objective is to win.